In this video, you'll see how you can automate IT operations and IT service management, or ITSM, with AWS Systems Manager. Using Systems Manager automation capabilities, you can decrease time to resolution of critical incidents, reduce manual effort, and improve your security posture at scale. Before we dive in, let's see how you can gain agility with control through automation. You can automate operations processes across environments. Integrate resource configuration, observability, and compliance data. Use predefined or custom automation runbooks. Configure any of your operations processes to trigger automations. Integrate ITSM solutions such as ServiceNow or Jira Service Management to eliminate manual processes. Perform automations at the resource level or in the context of an application or workload. And surface compliance data in AWS Config and AWS Audit Manager. We're going to look at two examples in this video. The first example will show how an AWS Config rule can trigger an event in Systems Manager that automatically addresses compliance issues through an operational work item, or ops item, in Ops Center. For our purposes, an AWS Config rule has already been configured to detect specified applications on Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud, or Amazon EC2, instances. If a resource is marked as non-compliant, an Amazon Event Bridge rule automatically creates an ops item for it. Let's go to AWS Systems Manager Ops Center to take a look. We can see an ops item was generated for a config compliance task. AWS Config detected that this EC2 instance is running an unapproved application. We can go into this ops item to gather information related to this operational issue. We can also leverage automation runbooks associated with this specific ops item. For instance, we can stop or terminate the EC2 instance. Notice that hundreds of other automation runbooks are available as well. For changes that need to go through a change approval process, we can leverage automation runbooks to initiate change manager change requests. In this case, we'll execute a runbook to initiate a change request to stop the EC2 instance. We'll enter the instance ID and specify the IAM role that's needed to execute the runbook. Now let's go to Change Manager to confirm that the request was initiated. We can see that the request was submitted and is pending approval. The reviewer will look at the change request details and then determine whether to reject or approve the request. Let's quickly look at how a reviewer would approve the request. The reviewer can enter comments about the approval, which will be logged within the request. Once the request is approved, the automation runbook will be initiated at a scheduled time, stopping the EC2 instance. Let's take a look at our instance. We can see that the instance is still in a running state. Let's refresh the page. The Windows instance is now in a stopped state. This example shows how we can automate IT operations utilizing AWS Config, Ops Items, and Automation Runbooks together with Change Manager. Now let's look at the second example of automating IT operations with ITSM and AWS Systems Manager. This time, we'll look at Incident Manager. Incident Manager facilitates rapid incident response to get applications working again. In this example, Amazon CloudWatch initiated an incident for performance issues detected on an application. Let's open the incident. We can see specific information related to resources for this incident. Let's take a look at the metrics. High CPU utilization was detected within our instance, which triggered the incident and notified all those involved. Within Incident Manager, we can also associate automation runbooks. Let's take a look. We can initiate runbooks manually or programmatically to automate IT operations and ITSM within the resources related to an incident. We can see that a runbook has been initiated and is currently in progress. Here we can see the runbook steps. The runbook is currently initiating the restart instance stage, which will take a couple of minutes to run. The automation runbook has successfully completed its steps. In this example, it restarted the EC2 instance. To confirm this incident has been remediated, let's go back to the metrics. As expected, the CPU utilization has dropped, indicating the issue has been fixed. We can now resolve the incident. The incident status is now resolved. We now have the option to create a post-analysis report to help expedite remediation of or eliminate future incidents. You've just seen how you can automate IT operations and ITSM with AWS Systems Manager. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.